trajo una de empleados, invitaciones, sacerdotales. Ay, dinaluhan namin noong January 22 hanggang 26. And the first talk was given by George Carlos Patron Wong, Archbishop Secretary for Seminaries, Congregation for the Clergy. At ito ang kanyang binigay ng fundamental principles of the new Ratio Fundamentalis Institutionis Sacerdotalis. So the first principle, ito ay sustainability of the Diocesan Seminary and the formative community. The seminary as an institution exists in the form of a Christian formative community. Not only the place where formation is received, it possesses a formative capacity in itself. The church in communion, the community life during the years of initial formation must make an impact of each on its individual, purifying his intentions and transforming the conduct of his life as he gradually conforms himself to Christ. Through interpersonal relationships, moments of exchange and discussion would result in the development of that fertile soil in which a vocation matures completely. Yet I am RIFS 15. Human relationships that are nurtured and interpreted by the grace of God and included by the gift of the priestly vocation are the ordinary vehicle for the transmission of values that will be fundamental for the future exercise of ministry. The experience of community life is a valuable element that cannot be neglected in the formation of those who will be called in the future to exercise true spiritual fatherhood in the communities entrusted to them. So there's a kind of a spiritual fatherhood and person of the formators. An educational community must have a sufficient number of seminarians. So yun ito problema sa atin dahil dito sa atin ay maraming seminarista na pumapasok sa ating senior high at then college natin ay marami at yung aakyat sa Tagaytay ay sila ay 19 mag-first year tag-take ng examination sa Tagaytay SPD. So 19 at kulang na yung ating mga bato nga sa Tagaytay. So, so 19 plus yung nag-regency pa, pero aakyat. So more than 20 candidates for first year theology. And then, a consistent team of formators. Yeah. A consistent team of formators. A qualified body of professors. And above all, it must guarantee a human climate that facilitates the development of every person as a man and as a disciple of the Lord called to be a shepherd. The bonds that are created in the seminary between formators and seminarians and between the seminarians themselves must be marked by a sense of fatherhood and fraternity. A fraternal relationship cannot just be left to chance. To fortuitous circumstances, but is rather a conscious choice and an ongoing challenge. So the relationship should be fatherhood and fraternity, not by fear, but this kind of relationship as of a father to the foreman. Second principle, gradualness of formation. So the values of faith and of the vocation are not learned once and for all. The person is placed on a journey towards evermore, where every piece of knowledge and every experience is progressive, because there is always another step to be taken. Accumulative, because the end already achieved continues to be an object for growth. In word, formation with the seminary is formation of disciple of Jesus, called to be a shepherd. Four stages of a disciple who is called to be a shepherd. First, the propedeutic stage, at least 1 year of duration, introduction to Christian life, and the formative process itself. So, sa ngayon, ay meron tayong senior high, 2 years. Noon ay, kung wala pa ka senior high, ay meron tayong pre-college, 1 year. Pero ngayon ay 2 years. It initiates the seminarian into spiritual life, completely by meditation on scripture, and by methods of prayer, through sacramental life, and through liturgical participation. It provides the seminarian with knowledge of himself, so that he may become aware of his principal virtues and defects, thus obtaining a map to his own personality. It makes him aware also of those points of difficulty that he must face and the strong points that he must expand and deepen. It offers the seminarian the necessary knowledge to understand his own faith and his vocational choice, and to fill eventual lacunae from his prior formation. It helps the seminarian to obtain a more objective and universal understanding of the apostolate of the Church. It is an introduction that is valid and necessary. Second stage is a stage of discipleship, or philosophical stage of 2 or 3 years of duration. Pero dito sa akin ay 4 years of philosophy. Pero sa ibang seminary, meron sila na dinidesign na 3 years. Pero ito naman ay iba ang gusto na DepEd. Ang DepEd ay 4 years college. So, accompanies the seminarian in the conscious and free affirmation of his choice to follow Jesus in a life of discipleship. Working at the foundations laid during the propedeutic stage helps the seminarian in his practical, systematic experience of spiritual life, personal and communal prayer, liturgical and sacramental life, a believer's interpretation of life, history, and life events, the development of the cardinal and theological virtues, all of which are features of a true Christian. Systematic work on his own personality, facing and death, through dialogue with the formators, his principal defects, and developing his principal strengths. The seminary must be conscious of not having hidden anything about himself, and of having placed a sufficient effort, particularly in his effective and sexual life. So, kinakailang maging bukas ang mga seminarista sa mga formators. Pero minsan, mga seminarista ay ayaw nila, itinatakot nila. Kasi yun ay takot sila, kailan maging dahilan na sila ay maring palabasin. Pero the new ratio is encouraging us na maging bukas ang mga seminarista sa mga formators. It is the moment to share his faith through pastoral activity, completely by catechesis for Christian initiation, and to acquire a critical and a believer's vision of reality all of which come about through the study of philosophy and the human sciences. The keyword for this stage is systematic formation, and the result that is expected to be achieved is a free man and a more authentic Christian capable of dedicating himself intensely and generously to his own priestly formation. Third stage, the stage of configuration or theological stage of 4 years of duration, helps the seminarian understand the mystical and ascetical journey of spiritual configuration to Christ, the servant, shepherd, priest, and head. Assumes an ecclesial and public commitment through the rite of admission into the candidates for holy orders. From an educational phase to a formative phase, the seminarian, without putting aside what he has learned in the previous two stages, starts to live out priestly spirituality, praying for the people of God, a more active and conscious participation in the mysteries of Christ through the liturgy and the sacraments, which is framed by the reception of the ministries of lictor and acolyte. A profound sense of belonging to the Church at a particular universal level. The Word accomplished to form his personality now acquires a pastoral sense, a bridge and not an obstacle between Jesus Christ and the people whom he is destined to evangelize. The seminarian puts forth everything he is and everything he has at the service of the gospel, deepening his spirit of poverty, celibacy, and obedience, which are proper to the diocesan priest. The study of theology is so profoundly linked to the formation program that the seminarian translates its contents into his spiritual, priestly, and pastoral life. Apostolic activity will serve to expand his vision of priestly ministry, especially in the field of the particular church, learning to value and actuate all charisms and vocations that are present therein and which constitute it. Therefore, the key word in these formative moments is specific. The fourth stage, the pastoral stage or vocational synthesis between the end of residence at the seminary and priestly ordination. It is marked by two fundamental elements. The insertion into a Christian community, be it parochial or of another type. The reception of the orders of diaconate and priesthood. The candidate for the priesthood must employ everything he has learned during this time in the seminary and give it continuity in the pastoral context of the community where he is raised, thus immediately preparing himself to begin his ongoing formation. An important part of this pastoral insertion is the participation in the presbyterate and in diverse priestly groups. The seminarian must realize in practice that it is about a common vocation, a common mission, which he shares with his brothers in the presbyterate. The key word for these days is definitive self-giving. Gradualness is a fundamental part of formative pedagogy. One can speak of the gradualness of these stages, as we have done. One can also specify the gradualness within each stage, thus tracing a formative itinerary with concrete means and materials, the object of the formative itinerary of every seminary. But we can also talk about the gradualness of every person and every group who mature according to their own characteristics and possibilities. Third, integrated formation. So the seminarian grows in an integral way, simultaneously cultivating the four dimensions of formation. A, during the first stages of the formation program, the seminarian must be presented with challenges for growth in every one of the dimensions, helping him to avoid finding refuge in his own strengths and instead opening himself up authentically to balanced growth, example sports, or for others it will be studies, still for others it will be fraternal life. So the second point is integrality. So in the formation, we should not departmentalize, but this should be a gradualness or progressive information. B, during the last stages, an integrated formation must be assumed by the seminarian in a more natural and profound way. He will become aware that he is more mature and complete as a person due to the harmonious cultivation of all four dimensions. See, during ongoing formation, the priest assumes out of his own responsibility and initiative the four dimensions of his formation, thus transforming himself effectively into the agent of his own process of discipleship and continuing his configuration to Christ, the servant, shepherd, priest, and head. Fourth, vocational accompaniment and discernment. A privileged means of priestly formation from the years of seminary and throughout priestly ministry is personal accompaniment. No one is saved alone. We are saved in community. Its formator should be possessed of human, spiritual, pastoral, and professional abilities and resources, so as to provide the right kind of accompaniment that is balanced and respectful of the freedom and the conscience of the other person, and that will help him in his human and spiritual growth. Kaya tayo ay ang iba ay pinaaangal ni Bishop, yung critical psychology na magiging guidance ng counselor sa ating seminaryo. At yung iba ay pinaaral sa ibang mga bansa na maging professional. Yes, this professional ability to guide and to give to the seminarians. An important element in accompaniment is trust, with which the candidate is able to entrust his life to another person, handing over his own intimacy. Respect, empathy, listening are among others the keys to help the seminarian grow in trust within an interpersonal relationship. When one feels heard, one learns to entrust one's life to another. The goal of the commitment is not only a knowledge of self, it must go beyond that. As Pope Francis reminds us, it must lead to God and must not remain at a self-contemplation or at an immanence without the possibility of arriving at the transcendence. The one who is being accompanied must be able to identify with Christ the Shepherd and must be able to, step by step, grow in likeness to Him up to the point of being able to think more like He thinks, to feel like He feels, and to live like He lived, to take His form, His appearance, until He repeats with St. Paul, "It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me." Thus, accompaniment comes to be a pedagogical and formative experience. This groundwork and pedagogy can be concretized in the personal program of life. In this way, the formator, like the seminarian, know in what direction we are aiming and what are the steps that must be taken in order to achieve the goal. Accompaniment must be present from the beginning of the journey of formation and throughout life, even if it requires different approaches after ordination. A serious discernment of the vocational situation of the candidate at the outset will avoid needless procrastination when it comes to making a judgment about suitability for priestly ministry. This will avoid leading the candidate to the threshold of ordination without having ascertained whether the indispensable condition have been met. Ayan na. Remember siya. Binasa ko lang po. Kasi ito rin ay dito rin sa binigay niya ni Archbishop Wong. Thank you, sir.
Siguro I just said na magkaroon tayo ng question and answer at this point. Bigyan mo natin ang kuwang muna si Emil because he's going to give us the second part or... Yeah.
Good morning, Obisha. Good morning, mga kapatid ko, mga pari. Nabanggit ni Father Josie Godupo yung buong principles ng New Ratio. Ngayon po, ang ibibigay ko sa inyo ay yung mga implications nito. And at the very end of the convention or the conference, Bishop Alminasa, who is the head of the Commission on Seminaries, ay nabigay ng mga paradigm shifts wherein ito yung pinaka-culmination of all the things that we discuss for the 5 days, full days. Not only of discussions, but of workshops. Kasi ho, talagang ang nangyari ho doon ay hindi lang basta nakinig, kundi talagang kinonsulta ho kami. So every day ay 2 times kami nag-uusap iba't ibang grupo just to widen and to really broaden yung aming pagtingin. So I will give to you, by the way, just for your information, so ang delegates na dumating ay 564. 497 delegates, priests, seminary formators, vocation directors, and vicar for the clergy, and lay collaborators. And 67 bishops. So, kaya 584 in number. Okay? Doon po sa binigay ni... Kanina po binigay yung principles. Alam niyo, isa sa mga sinabi ni Archbishop Wong doon ay for our formation begins at our baptism. Yun po yung napakahalaga na dapat maunawaan. Na ang ating daw pagbubog ay nagsimula ng kaibinyagan. At ito ay pinagpapatuloy na. Kaya nga po, dito po ay titingnan natin yung 12 salient points noong New Ratio at yung discussion for the 5 days. And then another 4 points para naman po sa mga concrete steps na gagawin. Okay? So, nice ko pong bigay sa inyo yung 12 o ba di 16. Pero may hindi na naman doon, don't worry. Okay? So, una po, ay binigay niya at binigyan din po sa New Ratio yung tinatawag na singular journey of discipleship. Ano po ito? Because before, ay departmentalize po ang ating formation. Pre-college department, college department, theology department, pre-diagonal program, diagonal program, preschool. Pero binibigyan din po ng New Ratio ngayon, eh hindi ito departmentalize, it must be unified. It is an integral formation. Kaya nga kung isa, kaya nagkakagulo kasi hindi maalis ko sa isang department, you know. So, walang connection yung isang department sa another department. So, it must be a progressive, ang term nga ni Archbishop Wong ay a progressive and accumulative. Ibig sabihin, progressive, nagbabago, pero na meron natitira, na-accumulate, parang sa ating philosophy of metaphysics, act and potency. No? Merong change, pero merong permanence. No? Yung accumulation. So, yun po yung napakahalaga po dito na binibigyan din, the singular journey of discipleship. The second point ay po tinatawag ng gradualness of formation process. Napakaganda po ng paglilinaw ng isang nagkapunto si Bishop David, because Bishop Pablo David ay isa sa mga napakatagal na formator din sa seminaryo sa Pampanga. Kaya napakaganda ng kanya, and I would like to share with you yung kanyang insight about, sabi niya, ay priestly formation does not necessarily lang yung seminary formation. Because there are two phases daw ng priestly formation. And what are those? The initial formation na ginamit ngayon ng New Ratio, ang initial formation po pala, yan yung seminary formation. And the priestly formation ay nagtutuloy doon sa ongoing formation. At ang sabi nga ni Bishop David, kaya sabi niya, humingi siya ng paumanhin doon sa mga bishop at mga pari, kasi dapat ang tatapik niya, initial formation muna, tapos ongoing formation. Ginawa niya, binaligtad niya. Sabi niya, hindi, gusto ko munang simula sa ongoing formation patungo sa initial formation. Bakit? Eh kasi yan ang mas matagal. Kasi ang seminary formation lasts for only 7 to 10 years or 11 or 12 years. Ongoing formation lasts from the ordination up to your death as a priest. Kaya kung napakagandang shift yun, paradigm shift na sinabi niya. Tapos to, minsan no, ito po yung binanggit ni Bishop, no, na ito po i-coach siya. Kasi ito po yung challenge sa atin, sa lahat ng Bishop, sinabi niya ho, sa harap-harap sa kanyang kapwa Bishop, sa mga pare, na minsan daw, minsan sinisisi daw ang mga formators kapag nagkaroon ng problema yung pare. Sabi niya, when a young priest messes up, often the bishop and the priest blame it on his seminary formation or formator. Sabi daw nila, he messed up. Something must be wrong with the way he was formed. Yet, sabi niya, what if the formator say, he wasn't perfect, but he did pretty well while he was with us in the seminary. He messed up after a few years of being in your company. What do you do with him? At yun ang kanyang challenge. Kasi nga, the shift from very well-organized programs of initial formation lasted for 11 years to almost non-existent programs of ongoing formation. Napakatindi po na sinabi niya. O nga naman, 11 years, tapos ito, ay buong buhay mo na parin ka. Kapag walang formation, ay papano na. Kaya nga sabi niya, common understood as end of priestly formation yung seminary formation. Henceforth, priests are on self-help, tinasabi niya, self-help mode. At ang ongoing formation equated with occasional opportunities for updating. Occasional. So, napakaganda po ng binigay na punto po na ini-Bishop David doon, na parang challenge din. Kasi nga, mas matagal yung ongoing formation, kaya doon dapat ang mas maraming programs kaysa seminary formation. Sapagkat ito ang buhay na hanghabang buhay. Pangatlo po, formative community. Pinalawak ko ng New Ratio, yung formative community. Pag sinabi yung formative community, akala lang natin ay seminary fathers, seminarians, teachers, benefactors, and all those things. Sinabi po niya, na ang format doon po sa New Ratio at doon sa ating discussion, ang formative community, una, nagsisimula daw po sa bishop. And then, priests, formators, candidate, family, and presbyter. Kaya ako, meron nga ako nagsabi, hindi ko lang matanda kasi, sabi niya, wag mo lang doon sa mga sharing. Sabi, sinasabi lang ni Pope Francis, na amuyin mo, di ba sabi niya, dapat daw inaamoy mo ang amoy ng iyong mga tupa. Ang sabi niya, kailangan mo din naman daw amuyin ang amoy ng kapwa mong pastor. Kasi kailangan mo rin na tulungan yung kapwa mo, pastor, yung kapwa mo, pare. No? So, yun po yung pinakasinabi po nung isang formator. No? And then, kakapag po, the need for ongoing formation of formators. Swerte naman po kami, sapagka kami po naman ay naka-attend na nung year. Yung year ay assisted intensification program. Renewal for seminary formators. So, lahat po kami, from the college, from the pre-college up to theology department, lahat po kami naka-attend na itong year for seminary formators. At sa mga magiging mga bagong formators, sabi atin po sila, kung meron man. Okay, so ito po yung nangyayari naman po. At ito po yung nakalagay din sa ratio. Kasi, never that God won't happen. You cannot give what you do not have. So, yun po yung napakalaga pong principle. Panglima po, importance of formation itinerary. Isa po sa ginawa po namin doon na workshop, nilahad po namin ang mga different formation itineraries po namin. Ibig sabihin yung mga ginagawa sa seminaryo, mga best practices, and then they will summarize all of them at yun po ay magiging bahagi ng bagong ratio nationalis. Ito po yung updated na po yung UPPF, pero i-update pa rin po. So, yun po yung mangyayari po. Okay? And then, susunod po ay yung renewal sa seminary, renewal at presbytery. Kaya ako yun po yung bibigyan din po diin ng new ratio. Kung paano nga po pa yung renewal ng clergy, renewal of seminary, renewal of the church. And then, ang ika-anim po na binigyan diin ay yung pong tinatawag na the new ratio. Ito pong ginawang new ratio noong December 2016 na na-issue ay sabi po ni Archbishop is for priests and his ongoing formation. Talaga pong yung new ratio daw ay ang intention hindi sa seminary lang, kundi sa mga pari mismo at sa kanilang ongoing formation. And then, 8, priestly fraternity is integral to clergy ongoing formation. So yung priestly fraternity po ay binigyang din ng new ratio na kung saan dapat ito ay talagang solid, mayroong pagkakaista, kahit pagkakaiba-iba ang presbytery. At lalo-lalo po, binigyan din po dito yung mga different levels. Kailangan na buo din yung bawat levels po ng mga kapalaran. And then, personal and pastoral accompaniment. No, kanina pa po natin narinig yung accompaniment. Kailangan daw po nito personal and pastoral accompaniment. Napanggit ko nung isang rubis po rin na napakahalaga daw po pala ng mga first years of priestly formation. Sabi rin po na Archbishop po, kailangan daw na yung mga unang pari ay dadalhin sa mga pari na parish priest na formators din. Kasi very delicate daw and very important na yung mga bagong pari ay i-assign sa mga pari na kasabay sa kanila, accompanying them into their new life as priests. So kaya nga po, yung new ratio ay sinasabi na hindi lang pala daw yung new ratio ay for seminary fathers, but for formators of ongoing formation. So yun po yun. And then, susunod po ay discernment. No? So napakahalaga din po yung paradigm shift ng discernment, especially dun po sa evaluation ng mga seminary fathers, sa mga seminarista, at kahit po sa mga candidates for ordinations. And then, susunod po ay school or formation house. Dati po, ang commission ng seminaries ay under ng Commission on Catholic Education. No? Ngayon po, ito po inilipat na sa clergy. Waka po na, ang pagtingin, hindi lang po siya educational community, kundi siya ay formative community. Kaya nga po, ngayon po ay more often, hindi na po tinatawag na school ang seminary, kundi formation house. Kasi po, just to underline yung integral formation na ginagawa si Binayon, which is not just an academic institution, but a formative community. And then, panghuli po ay yung vocational synthesis. Alam niyo, nakakatuwa ko, sapagkat nung aming sharing, doon po sa mga naghahawak po ng pre-diaconal program at saka diaconal program, eh, usually po, wala po sila program pa. Tayo lang po ay ilan, doon sa inilang ilang diocese na mayroong pre-diaconal, established pre-diaconal at diaconal program. So nakatuwa naman po malaman na meron pala tayo dito. Nito, na binibigyan din ng New Ratio, pero meron na tayo. So, i-ayos lang po. And then, isasama na rin po doon sa bagong updated ratio, nationalist. At ano po yung apat na challenges? After these 12 points, salient points, una, yung po propedietic year, yung po pre-college. Ito po ay magiging non-academic year, ang sabi. Pero napakahirap po kasi kailangan din naman na mahubog siya. Siguro po, ito po pag-uusapan na lamang po ng Commission ng Seminary Formation. Pangalawa po, ngayon po how to update yung updated. No? Kasi updated na nga po, i-updated, i-updated. No? So, pero po, ito po yung parang initial stage po. Ito po yung tinatinan po namin commission, yung ating conference ay unang hakbang pa lang po. Dahil talaga mag-uusap po yung mga different formators and different people na gagawa nitong updated again, no? Na ratio nationalist. At pangatlo po ay yung pag-establish ng team of drafters. So, yung muling pisa po namin noong Friday ay in-install po, binyasbasa ni Archbishop Valles, yung CPC-PC president po natin, yung team of drafters representing yung mga different places. Ano po? Different seminaries. Kaya po, sila po yung mamumuna para pag-usapan din yung mga proceedings ng lahat po ng mga discussions, lahat ng mga talks, at lahat po ng mga gagawin. And then, ang panghuli po, start with the UPPF and New Ratio Seminar Materials. So, yun po yung magiging materials for the New Ratio Nationalist. Yung po UPPF at yung New Ratio na binigay po sa atin and the seminar or the conference itself. So, basically po, yun po yung naging synthesis ng aming limang araw na pag-stay po sa Cebu City. Discussing about the New Ratio on Seminary Formation. So, marami pong salamat sa inyong pakikinig.
So, palay ko, meron po tayong mga questions. Kaya lang, time will not allow it. But don't you worry, after lunch, we will have, I think, quite sufficient time, no? Kasi by this time, we are supposed to be celebrating the Mass. So, hold your horses. Kung meron tayong mga questions, sulat natin. No? Kasi talaga maganda yung implications for us. Medyo may pagka-Copernican ng revolution. Eh, no? So, we will now proceed to the chapel and we will have the Mass. As we said, Mass for the dead for the reposing soul of Jesus.